Hey guys, it's Two New Games or Adam, and we are back with another COD Zombies Top 10. Today we're going over 10 things only BO1 zombie players will remember, and if you played zombies back then, these are things you should definitely remember. So I'm recording this video like a week before it actually goes up, because right now when this goes up, I'm at Zombie World Championships over in LA, and I had just posted our previous zombies video, and we already broke our like goal of 998 likes. Currently, we're sitting at 1,048 likes, so our goal is simple, to beat 1,048 likes on today's video. You guys have been absolutely amazing so far on the zombies content. We have broken our like goal every single time so far. Heck, we have crushed our like goal every time. So let's see how many more likes we can get on today's video. And of course, guys, if you have any future top 5 or top 10 ideas for zombies, let me know in the comments below. While you're down there and you see somebody else left an awesome idea, drop the comment a thumbs up. And besides that, guys, let's go ahead and jump into the number 10 spot. For things off, here in the number 10 spot, the weapons in Black Ops 1 Zombies are hands down the worst weapons in all of COD Zombies. This is something that I kind of now realize after playing BO2 and BO3 Zombies, looking back at all the COD Zombie modes, BO1 just has really bad guns. Of course, we're not talking about wonder weapons, we're talking about weapons in the box, and the majority of the guns in BO1 are mediocre at best. You know, in BO2 and BO3, we have a lot of guns that can do a lot of damage, you know, in the 20s and 30s, but in BO1, you only have a couple of guns that are actually good or good enough to take, you know, past round 25. Everything else is either mediocre or just really bad. Now, with that being said, the guns that were actually good were really good. They were really dominant, but the guns that weren't good were just overall really, really bad. And looking at all of it now, BO1 hands down has the worst weapon sets in all of COD Zombies. And next up in the number 9 spot, this one right here is kind of something I don't expect a lot of you to really know, even if you played Zombies back then. But if you look at the maps in BO1, the order that they released in was Kingdom 1-5 were the on-disk maps. Then you had Ascension. And what do those three maps have in common? They all have a viable trap. So the odd thing about this is that after Ascension, you do not have viable traps in any of the other DLCs in Zombies. In fact, the next time that we saw a viable trap in COD Zombies wasn't until Mob of the Dead in Black Ops 2, which is kind of a weird thing. It's not really a big thing, but still, viable traps were such a big part of COD Zombies, and then all of a sudden, they disappeared for so long, as in all of BO1 or after Ascension, no more maps featured that viable trap. Then, of course, in BO2, we didn't have it until Mob of the Dead, so kind of a little weird thing, but I don't know, viable traps disappeared for a bit. COD Zombies has a lot of really awesome music Easter eggs, and of course, it all started in Nocturne Toad in World of War, and as we've gone on, there have been some really awesome songs, and they get better and better, but nothing will ever beat Black Ops 1 5 music Easter egg, which was Won't Back Down by Eminem. For those of you that don't know, we're actually going to be getting the map 5 remastered in BO4 Zombies. It's going to be called Classified instead of 5. And man, I really hope they bring back this music Easter egg, because it's hands down my all-time favorite music Easter egg in all of COD Zombies. Who doesn't love listening to some Eminem while they're slaying zombies? And next up in the number 7 spot, if you thought Shangri-La was hard in BO3, you have no idea what's waiting for you back in Black Ops 1 when Shangri-La first came out. And when that map first dropped, a lot of people didn't like it because the map was so hard. Now, I know, Shangri-La in BO1 has PhD, which made, you know, Mustang and Sally's and the ray gun so good, but if you didn't use PhD, you're running around with a lot of mediocre or bad guns on a really close quarters map. It was not an easy map back in BO1. Coming in at the number 6 spot, one gun that doesn't really get much love nowadays has to be the ray gun here in Black Ops 3 Zombies, and in the ray gun was never this bad. It's kind of weird that the ray gun is so bad here in BO3, because BO3 has so many OP things, but the ray gun isn't one of those things. But back in Black Ops 1, let me tell you guys, the ray gun was the god gun. Now, I guess one thing that made the ray gun so good in BO1 was probably PhD Flopper, but even without PhD, the ray gun just killed zombies. Unlike in BO3, which it just makes crawlers on like round 5, the ray gun in BO1 would just insta-kill zombies in like the late 20s, which is incredible. And again, PhD Flopper made this thing so awesome. If you got cornered ever in a bad spot, just look at the ground and spam your ray gun and you will get out of any situation. So the ray gun in BO1 was so good. It was also good in BO2, but I think BO1 has the best ray gun of all time. Next up in the number 5 spot, we talked about how weapons were so bad in BO1 zombies in the 10th spot. And one thing that continues with the bad guns is when you pack-a-punch them, right? You expect a lot of these guns to get significantly better when you pap them, and unfortunately, they do not. But one thing that really bothers me about papped guns in BO1, not all of them, of course, but a lot of them don't give you extra ammo. It's kind of weird because after Black Ops 1, this wasn't really a big issue in COD Zombies. In BO2, I can't even think of a gun that had the same amount of ammo as a non-papped version. And in BO3, there was the X-M3 because that was a rocket launcher, so who cares? But all guns give you more ammo you pap it, but in a BO1, it was weird, right? Because you have a gun that's not that great, you spend 5k to pap it, it ends up being not that great, and you don't even get extra ammo. I don't know what was going on there. Coming in at the number 4 spot, this is a question I use in stream all the time. Which map features the first ever buildable? And the common answer, or the obvious answer, would probably be Transit, which really featured buildables and COD Zombies. But the first ever buildable featured in a COD Zombies map was in 5 in Black Ops 1. Now, of course, this buildable isn't like a turbine where you have to collect multiple parts. It's pretty much just one part. And on 5, on the top floor, there were actually 2 traps that you had to go and find parts for, or one part, and you went, grabbed that part, came back up, put it into the trap, and all of a sudden, you have the electric traps on that map. So, nothing too big, nothing too crazy, but for those of you who didn't play Zombies back in BO1, you probably didn't know that this map, or 5, was the first map to ever have a buildable. Coming in at the number 3 spot, you guys know how we have Mule Kick on every single map in Black Ops 1 Zombies. Well, that wasn't always the case, right? You didn't have Mule Kick on Nocturne Tote when it first released, or 5, or Kino, or Shangri-La. There was no such thing as Mule Kick until Moon came around. And Moon was DLC 4, which was the Zombies only DLC. And shortly after the release of Moon, they actually went and added in Mule Kick on every single map in BO1. This was the first and the only time Treyarch has ever gone into old maps and added in a new perk. And of course, every single map in BO1 has Mule Kick now, including the World at War remastered maps in BO1. And this is such an awesome thing. I really hope they can do something like this in BO4. Maybe there's like an event going on. They can have like a custom perk for that event. They can go back and add that perk in. That would be so incredibly awesome. But for those of you who thought Mule Kick was always there, it is not true. Coming in at the number 2 spot, we've had a lot of tough Easter eggs in COD Zombies. In fact, we've had a lot of tough Easter egg steps, like the Gorg Krovy boss fight or the Gorg Krovy challenges, right? Those are definitely tough, but it's definitely not the toughest in COD Zombies. And personally, I think that Black Ops 1 Zombies has the toughest Easter egg step of all time. And that step is the dial step in Call of the Dead. This Easter egg wasn't really all that hard until you got to this one step. And for those of you who played Zombies back then and you were doing the Easter eggs as it got discovered on these maps, the dial step always got me. I always had to find a random to do it for me because I never understood it. Heck, to this day, I still don't understand how this step exactly works. You have like 4 sets of dials, you turn one of them, all the other ones turn as well. It's so confusing. It's such a tough Easter egg step. And for those of you who played back then and the Easter egg was first discovered and you actually tried this Easter egg, you guys will know how tough this step actually was. Finishing off our list here in the number 1 spot, you guys probably thought that Fortnite was the first game to give out free DLC. That's actually not true. Call of Duty did it way before Fortnite, and back in Black Ops 1, DLC 4 was kind of free. This DLC was kind of free, but at the same time, it kind of wasn't free. But come on, guys, it's Activision. Of course, they're going to charge in some way for this DLC. And the way it works is if you either bought the Prestige or the Hardened Edition, those editions came with the remastered World at War maps. And if you bought those editions, you actually got Moon for free. If you did not have the edition, you had to buy the DLC, which included Moon and the remastered World of War maps, which was the first ever zombies only DLC. This DLC actually went on to win like DLC of the year. It was one of the highest selling DLCs of all time. And it's kind of weird because Chronicles set a record for the most DLC sales on PS4 and I believe on Xbox One as well. So when it's a zombies only DLC, man, it does really well. But besides that, guys, do the video, drop a like, subscribe for more COD Zombies content, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.